श्री गणेशाय नमः। ॐ श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। अखण्डमण्डलाकारं व्याप्तं येन चराचरं तत्पदं दर्शितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाखया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुरेव परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। शेयरिंग ग्लोरीज ऑफ लॉर्ड हनुमान द गुणवान विद्यावान दैट ही इज and so many people obliged to him, grateful to him. So many people have received his grace, the results of his blessings, his grace, his presence in their lives made such a big difference. If we could, you know, even a bit try and imitate and try and imbibe these qualities of Hanumana. So wherever we go, we are also considered such a blessing into another's life. They say, "Wah, from the time I have come across such a person, I have been benefited. This person helped me." You know, every time may not be with monetary benefit. It can be in kind. You can have a good word to speak to somebody. You can have a kind word to tell somebody. You can give solace. You know, you can hear people out. In fact, probably that's what they're looking for at any time of crisis. And if we can this way offer, understand we are already expressing that Hanuman quality within us. So here, after Tulsidas ji saying, you know, so many have tried glorifying Hanumana, but each one glorifies and then say, it is not enough. That is not enough. For he is much more than that. Also you will see, Yuga Sahasra Jojan Parbhanu Lilyo Tahi Madhur Falachanu. We saw how, because of the way he was, humble, pure, innocent, spontaneous. These are qualities that mark a realized person, a Jivan Mukta. They are very spontaneous. They are innocent. And because of that, for him, even a subject matter like enlightenment, Atmagnan, was effortless. Immediately, he got it. Just because of this nature of his, you will see in the next chaupais that Tulsidas ji has written, Prabhu mudrika meli mukh mahi jal dilang kai achra chanahi durgam kaj jagat ke jete sugam anugrah tumare tete ram duare tum rakhware hot na agnya bin paisare sab sukh lahe tumhari sarna तुम रक्षक काहू को डर। As I said, Hanuman ji as that param tattva, Hanuman ji as that jiva, a spiritual aspirant, as that Ishwara, all of this manifesting in the name, in the form, these attributes, you know, of his, all of it has been explained here in the Hanuman Chalisa. While he crossed over the Lanka, he had the strength to do it. Never once did he doubt. He said, this is Sri Ram Kaj, Ishwara's work to be done. And when asked, Hanumana, you would be able to go, won't you? He was reminded of his strength. He said, yes, I will be able to do it. Not only will I do it, since it is Ram Kaj, it is Sri Rama, it is Ishwara's wish. He will take care of it. I have nothing to do. So he is going to do it, knowing that he has the strength, he has the talent. His equipment is fit for such a thing. Also, he doesn't doubt. Bhagwan, are you sure I'm to do it? You think I'll be able to do it? No. He says, I will go ahead and do this. So when he is even crossing over, he doesn't allow, though he faces a lot of challenges, some in the form of comfort, you know, for the spiritual aspirant, for a spiritual aspirant to come to reach his destination, he has to have a samabuddhi. He cannot, what we usually say is, let me not look at the bad things of anything that is happening around me or the bad in any person. Let me only keep looking for the good. But the true spiritual aspirant who wants to see the truth of everything, he should maintain a samabuddhi. He should not seek comfort, goodness. He should not be seeking that. He should be seeking the truth. So whatever comes his way, if comfort comes his way also, he must seek the truth. He must not get carried away with the goodness and the comfort. Usually that is also an obstacle on the spiritual aspirant's path. He had to face challenges like Surasa. He had to overcome. Huh? But what about Mount Menak? He is a good friend of Ishwara and he said, I have to repay him. And I repay your father also, his kindness. So I am offering you place, comfort, to rest. You rest here, have something, and then you proceed. And then to that also, what does Hanumana say? No, I cannot do that. I cannot rest until I have not done what is asked of me, what is expected of me. So you see, he has a samabuddhi. He doesn't take to comforts and rejoice in that also. Just because that's coming his way. No. He says that may be coming in the way of my reaching Lanka. So my destination is important. These things are not necessary. Prabhu Mudrika Meli Mukhmai Jaladilangi Gaya Charachanai. That's what it means. What did he do? He had to leap in the air. He needed his hands. He needed his legs. So he put, Prabhu had given him his mudrika, his ring. Because how else will he be able to convince Sita Maiya that he is a messenger of Lord Rama? So Lord Rama's ring, he put it under his tongue and then leaped ahead. One way of looking at it is, he always had Sri Rama's name, Nama Japa, he was constantly doing. So his focus was on Sri Rama and not what he is about to do. Most of us, you know, we fail here. The moment you are told that what you're going to do is very tough, I hope you will succeed in this. The moment you're told that, what happens? Anxiety comes in. And then there is pressure that now you have to do. Till now you were not bothered about it. You were not worried about it. But just this much is enough. It's like that monk, you know, who wanted to walk on water. He wanted that siddhi because he wanted popularity. Nobody in this world did it, so he wanted to do it. He thought once he could do it, then he can become a teacher and earn a lot of money and he can be a great guru also to this world. So he went to one guru after another, whomever he had heard about, he went to all of them. He was tired. So many years it took him But nobody promised him that they can give him that. Finally, he goes, he crosses the Himalayas and finds a master there. As soon as he goes to the master recognizes. He has come very tired, and then he is asking for something like this. He says, this man is, you know, hallucinating. See, in spite of that, we don't give up our ambition, our dream. So he says, what is it? You rest. So he says, no, I can't rest. Can you give me this? This is what I want to know. I have not yet found a single guru who can do this. What is the point of their realizing their self? So then this guru says, okay, I will give it to you. You just rest a while because you are tired. In the morning, you take a bath and come and meet me at 4 o'clock. You have to take a bath and come. Imagine in the Himalayas at 4 in the morning, you don't feel like taking a bath anyway in the Himalayas. It is always cold. And then, so he is very happy, this monk. Oh, he has finally found a guru. So he is ready. He can't sleep all the night. He is excited. 4 o'clock in the morning, he takes a bath and he goes to the guru and says, yes, guru, I have come. Give me the mantra. So this guru says, what is the hurry? Stay here for a while. So he's trying his patience, you know. So he's told him, I can give you the mantra and I know. So he has watched this man. For 1 week, he makes him stay this way. And this man is seeing all the other monks and he's saying, oh, the inmates. So the guru says, see, look at what all practices they are doing. They are trying to get this truth come to recognize the essence they are. And what about you? You are looking for something like this. Don't you want to be doing this? He says, no, no, no. I've stayed here for 1 week. They're all wasting their time. Even I don't have any more time. Please give me this. Give me this mantra by which I'll be able to walk on water. So finally, the guru gives him. He says, okay, come to me. I shall give it to you. And then at the appointed hour, he calls him and he whispers a mantra into his ears. Asks him to repeat it thrice. He says, this is the mantra that will help you walk on water. And that man cannot believe it. After how many years his search finally is over. So he says, the only thing is, for this mantra to be energized, you must practice it in the morning, afternoon and evening. And when you have been able to successfully energize it, you must come and chant it in front of me. And then you can leave. You will see it works. You can walk on water after that. So he is all excited again and he can't believe it has finally happened. Before that, the guru tells him one thing. Just one thing. It's a very simple condition that you need to fulfill. When you're going to chant the mantra, ensure that you never think about a monkey. Ensure you never bring about a thought of a monkey at that. Anything else will do. Okay? So then what happens is, this fellow says, oh, what a strange request. And he says, anyway, I hardly think about monkeys as such. So that's no big deal. I can do it. Right? So then he says, okay, he can't sleep all night. He's waiting to get up in the morning. Energize the mantra, so he has to do it thrice in the morning, afternoon and evening and then go and present it to his guru. As he sits to chant the mantra, you know that condition comes to the mind because that's a great condition. So it says, I must not think of a monkey. And the moment he has said, the monkey has come right there in his mind. So he said, arre, why did I think of the monkey? I'm not supposed to think. But the monkey thought has come. Now, every time he is trying to chant, the monkey thought is coming. So he says, I'll take a rest and come. By afternoon, I'll chant it, try and chant it again. Again in the afternoon, as he sits, this time, it is not just that one monkey which came in the morning. You know. By now, some 100 monkey thoughts are coming because he is so irritated with that monkey thought that he got initially. He is trying to fight that thought, and in fighting that thought, there many monkeys come along to join the fight. After a while, whenever he is sitting to chant that mantra, he is lost. He is only thinking about the monkey. And after trying hard for 1 week, He goes back to the Guru, falls at his feet, and he says, please take back this mantra from me, Guru. Do what you want. I don't want to walk on the water. Take all these monkeys out of my head because I'm filled with that. This is what happens to us when we have to do, and especially when it is given with the condition, better do it properly or better do it well. Oh, you know, people are going to watch you. They have to know. Then automatically a lot of anxiety. You have the fear, you know, if you don't succeed, what will happen? All these thoughts come in. There is a lot of pressure. You have always been a good student. So that past reputation is there. So now you are very anxious. If you cannot do this job, what will people think of you? Hanumanna had no such problem. He had no, otherwise people are excited in the present moment only. They cannot think clear. They have no viveka buddhi, no sense of priority. What's to be done first? What should go next? They are always confused. They are seen to be doing lot of things and yet manage doing nothing. They pick up everything and everything is incomplete somewhere. Nothing is complete. Why? Because, no, they are rushing to too many things. You know? I have so much work. I am so busy. How could I complete? Then that day's work is also not complete. The previous day's work is also not complete and they are wrong. The anxieties of the present moment is worrying them. But not so with Hanuman. Why? Prabhu mudrika me li mukhmai jaladi langi gaye acharachanai. You know, nothing great. That according to him also, he says, what is there? I only had Sri Rama in mind. My focus was so single-pointed. What is needed to be done in this moment? If my mind is available at the task at hand completely, then in that lies its reward. So I am not worried about its karma phala, you know, as Bhagavan Krishna says, karmanyeva adhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. Never do you have, do not think, your privilege. You have a privilege to act, only act. Do not think about the consequences of your act. So constantly when we think, will I get it? Will this happen? Won't that happen if I do this? What will they think? What is happening is, you are not even giving your 100% to the act that you have to do. So a pure mind, we say, is that mind which is available 100%. When where your hand is, that's where the mind is, and that's where your spirit is. Then that job is well accomplished. This is what happened with Hanumana. One leap and he reached. He did not wait for Mount Menak's praise on him. You know, come and rest. No, I have no time. Sorry. Come, I have to eat you up, Surasasa. He says, you know, he used his sharp wit, intelligence to overcome that challenge also. And then he reached. So it is no great deal because a pure mind like his has to achieve this. There is no ego coming in between, no distractions coming in between. And Durgam kaj jagat ke jete sugam anugrahat. Whatever difficult job that is there, if we can bring ourselves to be like Hanumana, then that Durgam kaj, that really difficult job, is also becoming sugama, very easy. When we recognize it is our own mind which is, you know, causing all these problems, anxiety, because of the ego that is arising in every act that we do. We take a lot of kartritva bhava. I am the doer. What will happen if I do this? And if I am not appreciated, if I am insulted, and you know, we are worried about honor, dishonor. We are worried about so many things. The action has not happened, but the consequences of it has already eaten us up. So this is what we need to learn from Hanuman. How did he achieve this? He achieved it because there was no ego center. He was hollow within. Everything in the name of the Lord. Single-pointed attachment to the Supreme. Attached there, detached from everything that is going to take him away from that truth. So what is needed? At this moment, what is needed to be done, I am doing that, dedicating the entire action to the Supreme without bothering about what will happen, because that is anyway the Lord's wish. It is His will, not mine. So Prasad Buddhi, whatever happens after that, I accept it as that is God's will. Finished. Matter is closed there. How many of us can act this way? If we truly act this way, then every difficult challenge becomes easy. You learn to change that, you know, situation of challenge and difficulty into a moment of joy, because you enjoy overcoming those challenges have become your nature. Cheerfully you go through it, not grudgingly, not in pain, suffering, complaining. No. Never heard Hanumana complaining about it. Ram duware tum rakhware hot na agnya binu paisare. Ram duware, at the very gate, Ram duware, threshold of God, Godhood. Tum rakhware, understand? As though Hanumanji is there as a security guard and he will not allow you in. This security guard is very different. You know, usually security guards are standing there to see where you're coming from, and if you don't fit, they will check with the people also. They don't know where you're coming from, they find you suspicious, you will not be allowed. But this security card is very different. He invites more and more people into Ramji's house. Says, everyone is worth it. Come recognize that beauty of Ram. Come to see. How will you know? When will you know? Don't waste time over anything else. That way he is a Rakhwala. Also understand one thing. There is no shortcut to get to Rama. You have to go through this. Whatever or whoever Hanumana is. What does Hanumana represent? Humility, egolessness, wisdom. He expresses sattvic guna all the time. So, understand there is no shortcut. We cannot be from the tamasic guna. Think of, I have reached Godhood. Rama is with me only. Cannot happen. Full of tamo guna you are. This is why Vibhishana says, I am an asura. My body, my sharira is of the tamo guna. How can I even get to meet Rama? You see, he said that. To which, Ram duare tum rakhware. Hanumanji says, no. Don't underestimate. You worship him. You serve him. He shows you the way to reach God. That is how he is. That is the Rakhwala he is. And there is no other shortcut. You have to reach him through that. Karma yoga, bhakti, jnana, understanding who that Lord is, purifying yourself, worthy enough to be like Hanumana, dropping your monkey self, attaining to the godhood of Hanumana, you also reach Paramadham. This is how he is Rakhwala. Understand? From tamo guna, we have to go to rajo guna. From rajo guna, take ourselves to sattvic guna. In the sattva guna, we understand who God is. And that is how we can enter. Bhagavan Krishna tells Arjuna, nitya sattva stahabha, meaning you remain in sattva guna. Sattva guna has its own qualities. Being joyous, cheerful, receptive, sensitive. It listens. It speaks very little. It listens more. It is meditative in nature. Serenity is of the sattva guna. So how much are we absorbed in this guna? How much predominant is this guna? Okay? Only when we have this can we go through and enter into meeting, being one with the Lord. Ram duare tum rakhware hot na agnya bin paisare. Sab sukh lahe tumhari sarna tum rakshak kahu ko darna. When somebody is this way, you know, expressing with a lot of practice and actually putting, you know, these learnings into practice. There is no point simply knowing and expecting that the world will do this, you know, be kind and be nice. Everyone has got a very good morning message, suvichar in the morning, that we keep sending to each other. Good evening with a very good, be gentle, be kind, be honest. It is better to be honest than this, but we ourselves do not practice it. It's always for the other to be like this. So if we practice it, we put it into practice, then sab sukh lahe, you do not feel, there is no suffering then. Suffering comes because with my own ego sense, I hurt people. I get hurt. I am unkind to people. People are unkind to me. I insult. I grab. I hoard. I hate. Isn't it? All, I compete with others. This kind of ill-gotten qualities is because of the ego. When there is no ego, sab sukh lahe tumhari sarna, and one truly lives in surrender to the highest, that is existence, and in that, you know, one becomes childlike, like a infant, like a child, you know, a 1 year old child. How truly, completely it trusts its mother, isn't it? The mother might be a frail woman, you know, thin, absolutely weak. Huh? And then there is one hatta katta fellow who comes. The child will look at that hatta katta fellow and run to the mother only. Because it has complete trust and faith in the mother. The mother will protect me. It sees all the strength, but it doesn't go to that fellow. Why? Faith is like this. So that faith in existence, that faith in God, if one has, then that itself will protect us. That is what we must understand. When we walk the path of dharma, that dharma protects us. We must have faith in this. And when we have dharma, when we have saved and all the time spoken and acted to protect dharma, that dharma, if that is the protector, no, then we don't need anybody else in this world. We don't need people around us. You will be guided to safety. Sab sukh lahe tumhari sarna tum rakshak kahu ko darna. So you keep, when in duvida, keep Hanumana in mind and let him guide you. If we are not sure what is to be done, every dilemma is not very clear. Okay, in things where I know, give me the strength so that I walk the path. Where I do not know, let me have faith in Hanumana and walk the path that he has guided me on. Let me have the courage to walk that path. Then I am automatically protected. So keeping Hanumana in mind, we shall begin our chants today. Completely focus, be with Hanumana for these few minutes.
श्री गुरु चरण सरोज रज निज मन मुखर सुधारी बर नौ रघुबर बिमल जसु जो दायक फल चारी बुद्धिहीन तनु जानिके सुमिरौ पवन कुमार बल बुद्धि विद्या देहु मोहि हरहु कलेस विकार जय हनुमान ज्ञान गुण सागर जय कपीस तिहु लोक उजागर राम दूत तुलत बल धामा अंजनी पुत्र पवन सुतनामा महावीर विक्रम बजरंगी कुमति निवार सुमति के संगी कंचन भरन विराज सुवेसा कानन कुंडल कुंचित केसा हाथ वज्र और ध्वजा विराजे कांधे मूंज जनेऊ साजे शंकर सुवन केसरी नंदन तेज प्रताप महाजगवंदन, विद्यावान गुणी अति चातुर, राम काज करि बेखो आतुर, प्रभु चरित्र सुनि बेखो रसिया, राम लखन सीता मन बसिया, सूक्ष्म रूप धरि सियहि दिखावा, बिकट रूप धरि लंक जरावा, भीम रूप धरि असुर संहारे, रामचंद्र के काज सवारे, लाए संजीवन लखन जियाए, श्री रघुबीर हर्षि उर लाए, रघुपति की नी बहुत बढ़ाई, तुम मम प्रिय भरत हि सम भाई, सहस बदन तुम्हरो जस गावे, अस कहि श्रीपति कंठ लगावे, सनकादिक ब्रह्मादि मुनीसा, नारद सारद सहित अहीसा, जम कुबेर दिगपाल जहाते, कवि कोविद कहि सके कहाते, तुम उपकार सुग्रीव ही कीना, राम मिलाए राजपद दीना, तुम्हरो मंत्र विभीषण माना, लंकेश्वर भय सब जग जाना, युग सहस्त्र जो जन पर भानु, लील्यो ताहि मधुर फल जानु, प्रभु मुद्रिका मेली मुख माही, जल दिलांगी गए अचरच नाही, दुर्गम काज जगत के जेते, सुगम अनुग्रह तुम्हरे तेते, राम दुआरे तुम रखवारे, होत न आज्ञा बिनु पैसारे, सब सुख लहे तुम्हारी सरना, तुम रक्षक काहु को डरना, आपन तेज समारो आपे, तीनों लोक हाँकते कापे, भूत पिसाच निकट नहीं आवे, महावीर जब नाम सुनावे, नासे रोग हरे सब पीरा, जपत निरंतर हनुमत बीरा, संकट ते हनुमान छुड़ावे, मन क्रम बचन ध्यान जो लावे, सब पर राम तपस्वी राजा, तिनके काज सकल तुम साजा, और मनोरथ जो कोई लावे, सोई अमित जीवन फल पावे, चारों जुग पर ताप तुम्हारा, है पर सिद्ध जगत उजियारा, साधु संत के तुम रखवारे, असुर निकंदन राम दुलारे, अष्ट सिद्धि नव निधि के दाता, असबर दीन जान की माता, राम रसायन तुम्हारे पासा, सदा रहो रघुपति के दासा, तुम्हारे भजन राम को पावे, जन्म जन्म के दुख बिसरावे, अंत काल रघुबर पुर जाई, जहाँ जन्म हरि भक्त कहाई, और देवता चित्त न धरई, हनुमत से सर्व सुख करई, संकट कटे मिटे सब पीरा, जो सुमिरे हनुमत बलबीरा, जय 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 हनुमान गोसाई, कृपा करहुं गुरुदेव की नाई, जो सत बार पाठ कर कोई, छूट ही बंदी महा सुख होई, जो यह पढ़े हनुमान चालीसा, होय सिद्धि साकी गौरीसा, तुलसीदास सदा हरि चेरा, की जय नाथ हृदय महडेरा, पवन तनय संकट हरन मंगल मूरति रूप, राम लखन सीता सहित हृदय बसौ सुर भूप, सियावर राम चंद्र की जय, पवन सुत हनुमान की जय, उमापति महादेव की जय, बोलो भई सब संतन की जय।